Hi, welcome back. Welcome back. How's everyone doing today?
Good.
Excellent. Good. Excellent. Doing well? Let's talk about friction just a moment. Now, we developed these equations our last time. And we actually talked a little bit about friction. However, I want to define friction a little bit more. Right? Friction of something. I'm going to erase this here. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Let me erase this. Friction is a force that prevents movement. So if I have this eraser and I'm going like this, I can see that there's not very much friction. Yeah? If this were really heavy, it would be a lot of friction, correct? Mm-hmm. It would be a lot of friction if I pressed down. If I took the other end and I really pressed down, I'd have so much friction I would hardly be able to slide. So that would be a lot of friction, okay? So somehow friction is dependent upon weight, or maybe not weight, because the weight is reduced and it's actually becoming the normal. So if it's flat, the normal and the weight are the same, right? So let's look at it if it were flat, just for a second. So the greater the weight, the greater the friction. The less the weight, the less the friction. So there's some relationship between weight and friction. Now, as you remember, horizontally, Fn equals Fw. That's horizontal. Yeah? Horizontal. And the friction is actually an equation which relates a coefficient of friction. Now, that coefficient of friction is dependent upon a lot of different things. The nature of the surface, what it's made of, etc. So it has to be given to you. Mm-hmm. Unless you solve for it. You can solve for it. But in this case, a road is going to have a coefficient of friction. If that road is wet, it'll have a different coefficient of friction. Yeah. Civil engineers come up with that coefficient of friction. Let me just show you. So it's going to be Fn. So it's going to be based on Fn. So it's going to be a portion of Fn. Now, if it's horizontal, Fn is the same as Fw. So the harder I push, the greater the weight, the greater the friction, and that makes sense. Friction and Fn are proportional. They're directly proportional. Yeah? Now, if I look at this, if I wanted to calculate mu, that's a Greek letter, mu. If I wanted to calculate mu, I would say I need to know the actual friction. I could measure that friction. Or I could measure that, and I could come up with mu. Clear? So, in the next problem we're going to do, I'm going to give you mu.
Okay.
And then in another problem, I'll give you force of friction and the normal, and you'll have to come up with mu. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
But that's what mu is. That's what mu is, the coefficient of friction. That's actually how we calculate the friction. So, the force of friction could be given, or it could be calculated. Have a great day.